my God, I'm having a Mary. Because this lady did not show up. Oh, wow. This was
actually the most auntie shit ever.
Incredible. She said, I'll get there when I get there. To, like, and from there, people make their decisions. Mm-hmm. So, Rick's picnic day one. Interesting. It was cute. We got some pictures. We got to see Bilal and Robert Glasper. Everybody was running behind on schedule, and Jasmine didn't go on until like maybe an hour or two after her set time. It was really good. Jasmine's always going to deliver. She's always going to sing the house down. Turn up the mic, which I cringed at, I'm not gonna lie. And after Jasmine, it was supposed to be Mary. And we were like standing for as long as we could, oh my goodness, but we had to dip. Friend, how long was it?
It was almost 45 minutes.
Damn.
Yeah, I was waiting idly for her.
Yes, and like when you're just standing stationary, like not moving, not walking, like the gravity on your bones, you'd be like, whoa, I've never felt so heavy. Like I've never known I had this much weight that my ankles had to carry. And so it was just like a direct downward force, like 4 hours on end. And the crowd was feeling it. They were getting antsy. One thing about niggas, they're moving away. Like, it was actually low-key funny. Like, you could feel, like, you could hear people's conversations, the crowd. Oh my God.
It was the white folks still smiling in the stadium with the white people.
And not even, no, the white folks next to us were like, hey, 10 minutes to 11, it's fair to say that we gotta go. And the husband or boyfriend, whoever, was like, yeah, that's fair. So, everybody was feeling it, like, but they were like some middle-aged white folks. I'm pleading the case for Mary that it's not all her fault. Bilal, for instance, was supposed to go on the stage, right? Bilal and Robert Glasper was supposed to go on stage by like 4 something. We didn't get to the festival till like 6 something, and them niggas was on stage. Like, shit had been just delayed like shit, so. And then between Jasmine's mic and audio just being shitty, like I'm sure the audio people were taking extra time. And it was just not, it was just, people were irritable for sure. I also think Jasmine's mic not being on and not being able to deliver the full strength of her performance also like just put niggas in like a kind of an iffy mood, you know? Like we still tried to rally, but it was like, I wanna hear my bitch's pipes blow. Like that's what I came here for. That's what I paid money for, you know? But we have day two tomorrow. I don't even know what the game plan is, but we're gonna figure it out. I don't know. It's really giving, we need a blanket or chairs or pillows or something, like extended time to just lie down and chill, because all of that standing is for the birds. Like, child, I almost passed out, honestly. Like, black spots for a second. I was like, excuse me? Like, I'm not sleepy, so where is that darkness coming from? I need to get the fuck up out of there. Like, looked behind, just seeing a sea of people, not even really being able to see, like, an exit or the road, just, like, trigger my flight or fight mode, flight or fight, yeah. Mm-hmm. And I just told Nani, like, let's get the fuck up out of here. And we did. And we did. And we got ice cream. And I still feel kind of weird, to be honest. Like, I know I need to let my head down, but I'm on my yoga mat. I'm really glad I bought this foldable travel one because I really never know. And this is a good moment because I just feel so wound up tight from the stress and anxiety and oh my god, the bad vibes and stuff. But oh wow, that just decompressed my spine. Okay, let me stop talking because I know my friend wants to sleep. Good night, see y'all tomorrow. Good morning. Sorry for the awkward ass angle, but I do want to just check in really quick because we're getting ready to leave for Brunchiana. We are in Philly, if I haven't already mentioned that. I'm sure I did.
Oh Lord.
And I'm definitely gonna take the camera with me today because I saw niggas with their cameras. We're gonna go to brunch at Cafe Du Monde. Then we're going to Walmart for blankets because this standing shit, like I said, is for the birds. And bye. I wish I could come outside. Okay, we out.
Not these drinks, please.
Sure.
Philadelphia.
So we're praying at this point for a really good, decent sit-down meal. Cafe Du Monde, let us down. Well, Sankofa was delicious. Like, when they had so much dope-ass Black and African literature. I think they're owned by like a Somali
family. The favorite book I saw was the Charlemagne the God autobiography.
Oh my god, no, that was so, that, because that's vital for the culture.
It, like, its impact is just like, where would we be without that Charlemagne book? Without him and his like legacy, like,
yeah,
the work that he does, yeah, like, how he reaches people,
right?
You know, like,
right, exactly. Mm.
He's freed a lot of niggas.
Exactly. That was too far. I couldn't even joke with that one. That was too far.
And by niggas, I mean abusers.
Oh!
He's freed a lot of abusers.
And empowered a lot of stupid ass men to run their mouth, unfortunately.
To
and
he's run.
He's the original podcast.
I was gonna say, he's the reason why men over 25 get a podcast with their fucking
homies, and they have no range. You already know, bestie working as the photographer. Go like that. Okay.
I'm feeling like Houston right there.
Right. her.
OMG, headed to the Roots Festival. I'm about to change it to my Air Forces because
Henny, like,
we cannot do these all day. My little Polly Pocket shoes. I love them, but no ma'am, no ma'am, no ma'am. I just love it with the fit, but this is easier. Fuck it, we gotta make sacrifices. And I'll be damned if I lose this bag to this festival. Okay. I got my little hoodie to wear for later. I'm gonna wrap this thing up. I'm actually gonna tie it around my waist later, which, ew. So, 2007 middle school, but we just have to do what we have to do when we have to do it. You know what I'm saying? Y'all get me, right? I know y'all feel me. Child, I'm scared about my memory on this card, but God willing, inshallah, we will prevail. Down. Okay, headed to Uber. See y'all later. Bye. Look at my friend, y'all. One thing they gonna do is serve and eat, honey. That's one thing they gonna do. Exactly.
Friend, I'm ready to dance. My feet feel good. I love to hear that. That makes me so happy. Period. I'm ready to dance too.
Yeah, just a little something.
Just something slight.
Just a little slight. Like, just. Thank you. gonna say good morning. I don't know if I even said goodbye after yesterday, but yesterday was fun. We kind of conquered the festival a little bit better than we had the first time, the first day, which was cool. We knew more where to go, what to do. We saw Kamasi, Washington, which was killer and amazing. Ooh, let me just capture some of the cityscape for y'all. And whatchamacallit? Where all else? Oh yeah, we saw Keisha Cole. We danced with the niggas on the dance floor. It was just giving a lot more, like, less stressful. That's why I think it's nice when festivals are actually like 3 days, because that first day just be like, let me get my fucking bearings. But today's is giving very slow paced and slow moving. I think we're really tired. Today's Monday for one, and I already have to like check back into work because I'm not technically off. And I don't know, just having to get cute multiple days all the time and walk and be out and about and, you know, just getting organized and stuff. It is tiring, so I think we're kind of just taking it slower today. But now we're on our way to the, like, some cute sightseeing spots in Philly, just walking around, wanting to feel the energy and whatnot. Hopefully we can get ourselves a little bit of boba or like a smoothie or something yummy to eat. And yeah, that's really all that's going on right now. I guess I'll just check back in whenever we get to wherever we're going, and I'll see y'all then. Goodbye.
That's plenty.
Plenty.
Okay. Sammy, I got a capriccio salad
with grilled salmon and, like I said, coffee. Oh my god, all the chips and stuff. These are really cute though. I'm also just hangry.
Hangry.
That's also just
that looks amazing.
Yeah. Mmm. It's the goat cheese or feta cheese. I'm always gonna be a hoe for that. Oh, they're playing my girl Dua Lipa too. Okay. Bye y'all. Good morning. I'm on my way out. Now he's gonna drop me off at the train bus station. And is it showing like a 7 minute, 8 minute drop for you too?
It's saying 4 minutes.
I don't know. Oh wow. Okay, let's see. What time is your flight?
5.
DC was so good. Philly was so good. I can't wait to come back. There's so much of both cities to like see and experience. But I really like how we did it. It was like chill, not too high. I don't know, just like how you would say it, but like a lot of pressure. We were patient with just like the process of like getting to places and like patient with each other. And we actually talked about it, like how surprisingly after so many days together, we don't necessarily feel like killing each other, which is a great sign. Cause child, sometimes traveling with folks be so difficult. But we also talked about it, like even prior, like it was not, like as we were planning the trip, it was like never a sense of like hesitation or how it's gonna be. Like, I don't know, I was just really ready to see my bitch. So,
yeah.
No, seriously. And I'm so, so, so glad that we did this. I know though, like we're about to start doing these on a yearly, annual type of basis.
Period.
But we're trying
June is our moment.
Literally, we're trying to do
resort
relaxation type of thing.
It's giving spas and facials and massages every day. Like, bottomless drinks, buffet style eating.
Yes. Do we just want a cruise?
We're off the Miami resort.
Yes. Well, saying goodbye to the city. JT and Carisha, we out. Wow, the skyline is still so beautiful even up close. But anyway, on the way to the train station, I have my train for 1:30. It's 11:30, so we have a little bit of time.
I think it's where we passed.
I think so?
It's in here. Like, remember we were at the balloons and people could go down? I think it's right here.
Mm-mm. I don't think so. It's like across the water, I think. Here, look. Here's what my GPS is telling me.
Just follow this.
Okay. God willing, everything will be good. Tell me where I need to go. But I just want to check in because I don't think I did last night. I just had to stay in and do work, and we were off the eddy. Move, the nigga. What? No, he didn't just. Please, I'm screaming. And Nani caught up on some rest. Friend, you like slept like you were so tired too.
Still am. I'm literally sleeping all day. That's my plan. I'm gonna go to Target, get my storage bins, and then sleep.
Oh my
on
god. To complete the saga that's been happening at your apartment back at home. Motherfuckers should not touch your stuff without asking.
Feeling ass bitches.
But yeah, so it was a chill night in and just needed for us to like do laundry and, you know, get it together.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're on our way. I'm so excited. I feel so blessed and happy.
No, literally.
This like past basically week with you.
A whole week, honestly.
A whole week.
Well, 6 days, but might as well round up.
Okay. Bye, y'all. See you later. See you when I get to where we're going. Say bye, boo.
Bye.